हाथ से मिला के हाथ चलना हमें है साथ साथ, रास्ते रोशन यहाँ मंजिल करे नई बात बात, चलना है लेके काफिले, बढ़ना है मिटा के फासले, पाना है आज तो आसमान भी देखा है।
Be future ready at Rayat Bahra University, Chandigarh.
A very good morning to one and all, dear students and their families. This e-orientation program of 7th day and orientation program of Rayat Bahra University of Department University School of Sciences. I am Damini Arya of 3rd year BPT, Bachelor's in Physiotherapy from University School of Medical and Allied Sciences. Today, I'm being the host. I will welcome you all in the family of Rayat and Bahra University. So students, get ready to start a new phase of your life. And so we have the orientation program of USS Department, University School of Sciences. Due to this pandemic situation, we are not going to attend this orientation physically. So we are very pleasureful and grateful for the occasion that we are going to attend this in virtually. So I welcome respected Dr. Srimati Sheridgil. So she is the director and operation of operation and academics, head of Department of Life Sciences. She is well qualified and has 15 years of experience in teaching and research. She is gold medalist in MPhil from Punjab University. She is PhD in botany. She presented research papers in more than 30 international and national conferences. She is editorial board member and associate editor of many well-reputed international journals. So please welcome Dr. Simarjeet Kaur, ma'am.
A very good morning to all of you. So dear students, at the very outset, I would like to express my best compliments to all of you on the occasion of e-orientation today on behalf of Department of Life Sciences, Rayat and Bahra University. I am feeling very much privileged today to welcome all the new entrants as well as our existing students. And I must congratulate you on selecting the best and the leading professional university in India. And it is a known fact that we have a dynamic management, motivated faculty and devoted professors. You will be taught in a beautiful and congenial environment. And you have stepped into this university, I know, with fresh thoughts, high hopes, and aspirations. Trust us, we assure you that your ambition will be accomplished by the successful guidance of our beloved and experienced faculty. Our department, Department of Life Sciences, doesn't focus solely on the education, but it will mold you into a versatile person, develop the personal qualities such as leadership, teamwork, determination, flexibility, self-confidence, respect. We know the value of your time. So in addition to your studies, we would like you to get excellence in other areas, such as communication skills. We are working on your career enhancements and involving you into other extracurricular activities. Basically, we focus on the holistic development of the students. So dear students, hence, make a promise today that you will maintain a cordial relationship with each other and will be proud of this institution by being punctual, disciplined, along with your hard work over the time. And I would advise you to be extraordinary in every case, because whatever you do it with your full heart and you can achieve the excellence because you are having that potential, you are having that capability. You just need to channelize your energy in the right direction and you can achieve excellence in any chosen area. So once again, a very warm welcome to all of you. God bless you all.
Head of department. So I welcome respected Dr. Rajni Garg, head department of chemistry. She has experience of more than 15 years of teaching and research. Okay. So please welcome Dr. Simarjeet ma'am.
Well, students, now I'm going to start with the goals and the objectives of today's orientation. The goal of our orientation program is to facilitate the undergraduates and the graduate students to the values, expectations, and the resources of an inclusive Rayatan Bahara youth community. That will be your home for the duration of your degree program. So basically, Rayatan Bahara family, this is your second home, a home away from your own home. And to discuss the various career perspectives in your chosen area and the learning outcome of the degree. Now, let's come to the mission of the Life Sciences Department: to encourage and enable the students to develop inquiring minds and the curiosity about the science and the nature, to acquire knowledge, conceptual understanding, skills to solve the problems, and make informed decisions in a scientific context. Students would be able to communicate scientific ideas effectively, both in the oral as well as in the written format. And students will be able to think critically and to evaluate, design, conduct, and quantitatively assess the innovative research in a biological discipline, basically in the form of dissertations, minor projects, reports writing, research publications, and the research articles. Students will acquire the skills and the knowledge needed for the employment or the advanced graduate or the professional study in the discipline related area, so that when our dear students, they go out there in the market, they would be competitive enough to have that healthy kind of competition in the job market and can get good positions. And beside academics at Department of Life Sciences, we hope that our students must learn the intellectual engagement and the scholarly inquiry. They learn how to effectively engage and work with the academic advisors, and they will learn about the professional development and the leadership. They learn about the programs, organizations, and the opportunities that allow graduates and the postgraduate students to develop the leadership skills. And definitely, our students, they will learn about the rights, rules, responsibilities, in particular sections devoted to academic and the research integrity. And we are focused on the health and the well-being of our students, and it will reflect on the importance of the self-care and the care for the others. They will learn about the campus resources that support health and the well-being. Now, let's come to the Department of the Life Sciences. Department of Life Sciences at Rayatan Bahara University came into existence in the year 2016 under University School of Sciences. Department of Life Sciences aspires to be the foremost center for learning nationally and internationally through the pursuit of academic excellence, admirable research in the biological sciences. By promoting innovation and entrepreneurship skill, critical thinking, and definitely scientific temperament, and by focusing on the holistic development of the individuals. Basically, this department provides optimum platform for the students to realize their true potential and to sharpen up their scientific skills. And the students, mostly they are from the medical background, they are from the life sciences, so they are very much involved into the research and the development. The department strives to build up the academic aptitude for the leadership in knowledge propagation, especially in research and the development. So the research scholars at the master's level and the doctorate level, they get very congenial learning ambience and well-equipped laboratories to develop their intellectual, academic, and scientific skills through the practical training. Department also endeavors to create awareness for among students and masses for the sustainable development by adopting various systematic approaches for the environment conservation and the management. Now let's talk about the programs offered by Department of Life Sciences. Department of Life Sciences is currently running undergraduate, graduates, postgraduates, and doctorate program. We are having BSc Life Sciences, MSc Botany, MSc Environmental Sciences, PhD Botany, and PhD Environmental Sciences. So let's brief up about the study program so that the students who have joined into the undergraduate and the postgraduate courses, they may come to know about the objective of these programs and the learning outcome. So objective of BSc Life Sciences, during these programs, the students, they will acquire basic knowledge of principles and the processes underlying life sciences. Graduates will develop essential skills to conduct the independent research in life sciences, such as biochemistry, microbiology, biotechnology, plant physiology, and others life sciences related areas. Now, when it comes to the learning outcome of BSc life sciences, students will acquire oral and communication skills. They will develop the scientific temperament, communication skills, and ethical practices, and definitely biosafety guidelines in the pursuit of the sciences. Now, next comes our postgraduate program, MSc Botany. The objective of this program is the holistic development and the academic excellence to contribute effectively to understand of the subject, to equip the students with the basic skills in identifying and labeling the different plants. As the students, they are from the botany, that simply means the study of the plants. So the students, they get those basic skills, how to identify those plants and to label those plants, and they can contribute significantly in the research development. To impart quality education in the field of botany, enabling our students to confidently face the job market, to sensitize the students towards the need for keeping the environment clean and conserve our natural resources. Now, when it comes to the learning outcome of MSc Botany, the students, they would be benefited with the knowledge of core subjects like plant diversity, physiology, biochemistry, molecular cytogenetics, and the application of the statistics. We have made this research and methodology, and the biostatistics is the mandatory part of our postgraduate program, so that when our students, they are, as I said in the beginning, our students at the graduate and the postgraduate level, they are very much involved into the research activities in the form of giving them the minor projects, major projects, and the dissertations. So they are very much involved into the laboratory experimentations. So research and methodology, which the students generally in the other universities, they study at the doctorate level or the master's in philosophy, our students, they have already been studying at the postgraduate level. They are equipped with the modules on the analytical techniques, plant tissue culture techniques, plant physiology, that would really help them in doing the research work. Now, the future or the career prospects for the students studying this course. Job avenues, I have mentioned only few of them. Definitely after qualifying UGC NET, the students, they can join as a lecturer in the colleges and the universities. Besides, they can get actively involved into the research activities. They can act as a plant pathologist, environmental consultant, molecular biologist, plant biochemist, taxonomist, and the ecologist. And these graduates and the postgraduate students, they can find various employment opportunities in the biotechnology firm, herbal product company, and the various research organization. These are just the few of the, the future aspects that I have mentioned over here. Now, the next are very effective and the potential program is MSc Environmental Sciences. Basically, environment science, we know that as per the Ministry of the Education and the UGC guidelines, it is a mandatory subject even in the school, colleges, and the universities. So it is an interdisciplinary subject and involves studying the elements of the biology, chemistry, physics, geography, and social sciences. So basically, it is a combination of pure sciences, applied sciences, as well as the social sciences. So during this program, the field work is a key part of studying the environment science, focusing on a particular ecosystem, and it involves a significant amount of work in a single location. And when it comes to the laboratory work, it is also a core element of studying environmental sciences. And as a part of degree, you will learn how to test, analyze different samples and to interpret the results and to use those results basically for the upliftment of the environment. The objective of this program is to create and disseminate knowledge to the students about the environmental problems at the local, national, and the international levels, to provide the practical training on the modern instrumentations and the analytical techniques for the environmental analysis, to sensitize the students about the various environmental issues at the local, national, and the international levels, and to prepare the students for the successful career in the environmental departments, research institutes, industry, consultancies, and NGOs. So basically, our motive is to the employability of our students, whether they join any kind of course, a postgraduate course in any field of sciences. And dear students, when I'm talking about University School of Sciences, that simply means University School of Sciences, it constitute of Department of Life Sciences, Department of Chemistry, Department of Physics, Department of Mathematics. So four departments collectively constitutes University School of Sciences. Now the learning outcome of the MSc Environmental Sciences, these students, they will be having this fundamental knowledge of the different aspects of the environment to solve the various environmental problem. And they will obtain exposure to the environmental pollution control techniques, and accordingly they can work in the pollution control board, and they will acquire the skills in the preparation, planning and the implementation of the environmental projects. So whatever you learn during this program in MSc in Environmental Sciences, you would be able to execute those ideas, those analysis, those that research work in the implementation of the environmental projects. Now, few future career prospects I have mentioned over here for the students out there listening to me in the MSc Environmental Sciences. The students passing MSc degree in Environmental Sciences, they will have the various, they will in fact have the endless opportunities in this field. Beside working in the academics and the research, they can work in the effluent treatment plants of the various industries, companies and the factories. They can work in the municipal councils and the corporations. They can work at the Central Pollution Control Board as well as the State Pollution Control Board. They can could be a part of the National Research Institutes organization. They can work in the laboratories like NIRI, Environment Impact Assessment, Geological Information Survey, and they could be a significant part of the environmental monitoring projects. And they can work as an environmental consultant also. And most importantly, our students for MSc Environmental Sciences, they can join Wildlife Department, they could be a part of the Forestry Department, and they could be a significant part of the these water purification and the treatment plants and other sectors related to the field of the environment. Again, these are the few fields that I have mentioned over here. Otherwise, you will be having those endless opportunities. So I would like to brief up the evaluation process for the students listening me out there. At Riatan Bhara University, we are offering this choice-based credit system. And under this system, the students, they will be having this continuous assessment and continuous evaluation. So throughout the semester, the students, they are under our observation. They are under our radar, in fact, I would like to say. And I would like to tell you, in 1 year, we are having two semesters. And in one semester, we conduct two MTT, mid-term tests, right? And the one MTT is of 30 marks. That, again, varies from department to department. And at the end, the average of these MSTs or the mid-term test, that is added into your final evaluation, like in your end-term examination. And when I say the continuous evaluation is there, that means you have to prove your potential, you have to earn these points by various presentation, by giving seminars, or you are conducting the classroom, or the behavior in the classroom, your attendance, your discipline, your punctuality. So we will be assessing you for these 20 marks. This is a continuous evaluation. And in totality, the 50 marks are there. And these 50 marks will be added into your end term examination. So it's not entirely you appear in the final examination and that's it. This is mandatory. You have to be part of this continuous evaluation. Likewise, for the practical session, we have been following the same pattern that you can see in this slide. Now, let's come to the faculty and the intellectual property of the Department of the Life Sciences. Department of Life Sciences has well-experienced and the qualified faculties who have had their degrees or worked with the institutes of the national and the international repute and are highly devoted to teaching as well as research. So department is also actively involved in organizing various conferences, seminars, workshops, and placements of the students since its inception. This is the faculty of the Department of Life Sciences. This is myself, Professor Dr. Simarjeet Kaur, HOD Life Sciences and Director of Operations and Academics at Riatan Bhara University, Mohali. Professor Dr. Amita Mahajan, specialized in botany and also heading Department of Agriculture. Professor Navdeep Kaur, she is specialized in botany. Professor Alice Sikkan, she is specialized in zoology as well as in environmental sciences. Professor Bandeep Kaur, specialized in botany and environmental sciences. Then we are having our lab instructor, Ms. Kanchan Rawat is there, and few guest faculty and the visiting faculty from the renowned universities and the research institutes. So basically, the invitee speakers, they are an important part of our department, and you keep on learning the kind of technology, the methodology they have been using in their own research institutes. So this is basically to aware you about the recent trends in the science and the technology. Now, I have listed over here the few activities of the life sciences department. Expert talks, academic workshops are there, national symposium, national science day celebration, you can see World Wetland Day celebration, International Women's Day celebration, Environment Day celebration, Independence Day celebration, Teachers Day celebration. Then definitely as a part of their curriculum, the students, they are having their industrial visits, scientific laboratory visits, botanical garden visits. So these are the few of the activities that I have listed over here. These are the glimpses of a few of the activities organized by the Department of the Life Sciences under University School of Sciences. As I already said, few activities which we conduct at the national and the international level are jointly organized by the University School of Sciences. So this, under the Mission Innovative Punjab, Women in STEM, in Science, Technology, Engineering, Management. So this was the joint efforts of the University School of Sciences, and in which the girl students from the science and the technology, they actively participated in this program and shared their innovative ideas in the field of the science and the technology. Now, as per we have made it mandatory, we invite, the speakers or the expertise in the field of the life sciences to share their views and to enlighten up our students about the recent trends in the life sciences. So we keep on organizing such kind of the expert talks under Department of Life Sciences. Now again, the National Symposium in the Recent Trends in Science and Technology was organized by the University School of Sciences. Again, this was the collective effort of all the departments of the life sciences, physics, chemistry, and the mathematics. And where the students, we receive a huge participation across the nation, across the India, from the various states of the India. I have put few pictures of the scientific visits and the botanical garden. Basically, what we teach our students in the classroom, that is a theoretical part, what we teach our students. But when they go out there in the field, they learn about they get that practical training of the theoretical concept taught in the classroom. So botanical visits, garden visits, or the scientific visits, they are a mandatory part of our students' curriculum. So our students from the Department of the Life Sciences, they visit botanical garden every year so that they can go there, they can identify the various plant species, and accordingly they can label it, and they get that practical knowledge. See, if we will keep on showing them the pictures on the laptop or on the projector, definitely they wouldn't be able to understand that much. So our students, we push our students to go out there in the field and to identify and to learn the practical concepts of the things that we teach them in our classrooms. This educational trip is also a mandatory part of the curriculum for the Department of the Life Sciences. You can see the students visited this year Missouri, and they collected 150 plant species. So you see, the students, they went into the field, they learned about they collected the plant species, not only plant species, they collect the few, edible mushroom, non-edible mushrooms, or the poisonous mushroom. They collected to understand the host parasite pathogenicity. They collected fungal specimen, algal specimens, as well as bryophytes. So that collection, they brought back into the laboratory, they identified those species, they labeled it, then they set up their own herbarium at the Department of the Botany. So that kind of learning experience you get at Department of Life Sciences. A few glimpses of the activities celebrated by the Department of the Life Sciences. International Women Day was celebrated by the Department of the Life Sciences to mark the significance of the women in various fields and to understand their importance, how much they have been contributing in the upliftment of the society. And our department, Department of Life Sciences, is already dominated by the girl students. And they are the heart of our department. And they keep on organizing such kind of activities and actively participate in these extracurricular activities. Now, few inter-university competitions organized by Department of Life Sciences. You can see in this slide in which we invited one of the event where we invited the students from the schools and colleges across the India. Students visited our labs, not only lab of life sciences, they visited the different labs of life sciences, physics, chemistry. And they learned a lot about the, you know, the activities or the experiments performed by our own very students. So it was really a matter of proud for us, like our students at the graduate and the postgraduate level, they were performing. The faculty was not performing any kind of experiments. Our students who have just joined, you know, even the first year, the second year students, they performed experiments for the visitors, for the students from the outside, for the plus two level, even for the graduate students. You can see, so that kind of learning that we have been offering at Riyatan Bhara University in the Department of the Life Sciences. So again, few slides are there. This is a very, you know, I would like to say memorable moments of the last year Teachers Day celebrations. This year we had this virtual Teachers Day celebration, and we are really proud of our students, like they actually made our day. And they paid a tribute online by organizing various activities to celebrate this Teachers' Day under this pandemic situation. Now, you know, Riyatan Bhara University has always been actively participating and conducting activities under corporate social responsibility and education social responsibilities. And Department of Life Sciences is a very, you know, active member. And giving its significant contribution in the implementation of these kind of activities. These activities we have been conducting in under the Ministry of the Education and in collaboration with the DPI Chandigarh. So on different projects, whether it's Prime Minister Narendra Modi project or any Ministry of Education project, so we keep on conducting such kind of activities for the noble cause, for the social cause. So a few activities like on the water conservation, on the drug abuse, you can see in these slides, on Kuposhan awareness, on cyber security, under NSS, number of activities has been conducted by Department of Life Sciences on behalf of Riyatan Bhara University. Industrial visit, I said, again, this is a mandatory part of our graduate and the postgraduate students. So every year they have been visiting these industries, the scientific organizations and the various laboratories to understand the practical, to get that practical learning over there and to understand the various equipments or the instruments being used in those laboratories. I have put few slides of the media coverage. Achievements of the life sciences. I have already talked about it. Our students, they have set up their own herbarium at the botany department. And then we are having a well-equipped laboratories. Then we have made it mandatory for our students, even at the graduate and the postgraduate level, to promote research temperaments in the students. So dissertation, minor projects, and the major projects are very much essential for the students if they want to get the degree. Okay, then we focus on the research publications at the postgraduate levels. Our students, they are writing research publications, writing research articles at the graduate as well as the postgraduate level. And they have been given free UGC NET preparation at the same time. So this kind of learning, we actually trying to inculcate each and every kind of scientific and the technical quality into our students and to make them employable in the market. Few students' achievements of Department of Life Sciences. Students graduated from our university, from the Department of Life Sciences. They are actually pursuing their post-graduation at the national and the international universities. Many students, they already got admission in the foreign university, in the MBA, in the healthcare management. Many students, they are working in the science laboratories and assisting the pathologist and the microbiologist. Even this year, our students, they got selected for the TIFR-GS, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, for the graduate scholarship. You see, the students who are graduating or post-graduating from the Department of Life Sciences, they are actually excelling out there in the field. And our PhD scholars, they are holding up well-reputed positions in the academic and the research institutes, because the Department of Life Sciences is having a very good number of the research scholars, PhD scholars in the area of the botany as well as in the environmental sciences. faculty achievements, HOD Life Sciences received Best Teacher Award by the Indian Society for the Technical Education, New Delhi, and Gold Medalist from Punjab University, Chandigarh. Our faculty members, they have published a paper into national and the international journals like UGC Approved, SAI and Scopus Journal, and received highest citations for the research publications. They are the editorial board member of many national and the international journals, and lifetime members of many national and international scientific society. And the faculty that is UGC NET qualified. So as per the UGC norms, we have recruited our faculty members. So students, I would like to tell you, you are at a very safest place, and your learning will be much more better, and it will make you more richer when you join this Department of Life Sciences. And our department, yes, definitely, if we have been inviting the persons from the outside, our department, the faculty from our department, they are also working as a resource person and the invitee speaker for very renowned universities and the research organizations. This is few of the faculty achievements. So I would like to end up this now, because we are already having three more speakers from the University School of Sciences, HOD Chemistry, then HOD Physics, HOD Mathematics. So dear students, I would like to end up with this quote: an investment in the knowledge pays the best interest, by the Benjamin Franklin. This simply means education requires costly resources, and those costly resources are the time and the money, and which are often hard to find. We know that money is hard to find, as well as time is very much hard to find in this busy schedule of all of us. But those who do invest in these resources, they often end up richer, right? Not just because they often improve their financial situation. Sometimes to don't get money, you don't improve your financial situation, but because their minds are richer too. Your minds, they become very much richer when you gain any kind of education. So if you have invested into the education, your education and your knowledge, that is the only one thing no one can take away from you. So thank you very much. Best wishes for your bright future. So stay tuned, stay safe. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable words. So now I'm going to introduce the head of department of. So I welcome respected Dr. Rajni Garg, Head Department of Chemistry. She has experience of more than 15 years of teaching and research. She received her Master's of Science in Chemistry from Punjab University and PhD from GKU Uttarakhand. She is also editor of Communication in Physical Sciences, published by University of Nigeria. She published 3 books and co-authored many books and chapters. So please welcome HOD of Chemistry of Department USS. So over to you, ma'am.
Good morning, one and all. It's my proud privilege to introduce the distinguished Department of Chemistry, exploring in the field of chemical sciences under rigorous, vibrant, and innovative environment of Riyad Bahra University. I welcome all the students and their parents in this session of e-orientation. Now, please let me allow to take you in the amazing world of chemistry. Chemistry is a central science. Chemistry is the scientific discipline that works at the intersection of mathematics, physics, biology, and environmental science. It provides knowledge about all physical, chemical, and biological processes. It is an integral part of the several disciplines and significantly contributes towards nation's economy. As you all know that
हाथ से मिला के हाथ चलना हमें है साथ साथ, रास्ते रोशन यहाँ मंजिल करे नई बात बात, चलना है लेके काफिले, बढ़ना है मिटा के फासले, माना है आज तो आसमान भी देखा है।
Be future ready at Royat Bahra University, Chandigarh.
से मिला के हाथ चलना हमें है साथ साथ, रास्ते रोशन यहाँ मंजिल करे नई बात बात, चलना है लेके काफिले, बढ़ना है मिटा के फासले, माना है आज तो आसमान भी देखा है।
Be future ready at Royat Bahra University, Chandigarh. से मिला के हाथ चलना हमें है साथ साथ, रास्ते रोशन यहाँ मंजिल करे नई बात बात,
चलना है लेके काफिले, बढ़ना है मिटा के फासले, माना है आज तो आसमान भी देखा है।
Be future ready at Rayat Bahara University, Chandigarh. हाथ से मिला के हाथ चलना हमें है साथ साथ, रास्ते रोशन यहाँ मंजिल करे नई बात बात, चलना है लेके काफिले, बढ़ना है मिटा के फासले, माना है आज तो आसमान भी देखा है। Be future ready at Rayat Bahara University, Chandigarh.
से मिला के हाथ चलना हमें है साथ साथ, रास्ते रोशन यहाँ मंजिल करे नई बात बात, चलना है लेके काफिले, बढ़ना है मिटा के फासले, पारा है आज तो आसमान भी देखा है।
Be future ready at Rayat Bahara University, Chandigarh.
सर इसको
Sorry for the inconvenience. Due to some technical error, we had to take some pause. So once again, I welcome you all in this e-orientation program. And it's my proud privilege to introduce the distinguished Department of Chemistry, exploring in the field of chemical sciences under rigorous, vibrant, and innovative environment of Rayat Bahra University. Chemistry is a central science. It is the scientific discipline that works at the intersection of mathematics, physics, biology, and environmental science. It provides knowledge about all physical, chemical, and biological processes. It is an integral part of the several disciplines and significantly contributes towards nation's economy. We, the human beings, are itself made up of biological compounds. So, right from our birth, and the life we live, the food we eat, the water we drink, the various processes we perform that are undergoing autonomously in our body, as well as all the industrial processes, each and everything involves chemistry. So keeping the importance of this amazing science in consideration, we have started the courses in chemistry at our Department of Chemistry, Rayat Bahra University, Mohali. The basic aim is to provide interdisciplinary educational and research experience to our students with building of a strong technical foundation so that they must be able to meet the needs of the various sectors, including industry, research, education, and entrepreneurship. We are determined to implement appropriate education strategies and processes through a future-oriented curriculum using the adequate management and support by academically rich faculty and infrastructure. We aim to promote research at undergraduate and graduate level by fostering the interdisciplinary collaboration. We are determined to exemplify professionalism, diversity, and integrity as a set of core values in our future chemists. Now, the important objectives, keeping in mind, we have offered various courses at our Department of Chemistry to cater to today's need. Department offers BSc Chemistry honors at the undergraduate level, MSc Chemistry and MSc Pharmaceutical Chemistry at the postgraduate level, and PhD courses. Our curriculum is solid, rigorous, and well-planned based upon the choice-based credit-based system. First of all, about BSc Honours Chemistry, the basic eligibility is plus 2 medical or non-medical or equivalent with 50% marks for general category. About MSc Chemistry, the academicians, researchers, and industry persons require a thorough and deep knowledge of chemistry so as to gain skills from problem solving and face significant challenges at the interface of science, engineering, and technology. Keeping this in consideration, MSc Chemistry is based upon choice-based credit system with an inter or multidisciplinary approach to provide insights in various aspects of inorganic chemistry, physical chemistry, organic chemistry, and computational chemistry. The program is based upon cultivation of the interest of the students in theoretical and experimental chemistry and enabling them to build a successful career in academics, industry, or research. The program includes subdisciplines of biochemistry, environmental chemistry, polymer chemistry, photochemistry, and more. The program carries out overall development of the students by providing the intellectual, scientific, and practical exposure through industrial or scientific visits, seminars, workshops, trainings, project work, dissertation, etc. The research labs at the department are equipped with sophisticated instruments, including batch reactors, UV visible spectrophotometers, HPLCs, etc., and provide a learning environment to the students with hands-on experience in the field of nanochemistry, alternative fuels, green chemistry, and analytical chemistry. Now about pharmaceutical chemistry. In the today's scenario of COVID-19 pandemic, pharmaceutical industry is growing at a tremendous pace, with opening of new horizons, providing ample opportunities to the skilled professionals for the development and analysis of new drugs. Pharmaceutical chemistry program incorporates the core disciplines of organic chemistry, biological chemistry, and pharmacology. It is aimed to provide enhanced technical skills in design, synthesis, and development of pharmaceuticals. Students will not only gain an in-depth understanding of the theoretical and experimental aspects of the field, but also will be able to enhance their analytical and research skills along with simultaneous development of interpersonal skills, time management, and organizational skills. The program intends to form a good base for research and further higher studies, as well as strives to meet the requirements of pharmaceutical industries by providing in-depth knowledge of the research field of specialization. The location of university near the hub of pharmaceutical companies is a boon to provide required training and ample job opportunities to the students. Regarding the eligibility, any student with final year course passed out from B-Pharma, BSc Medical, Non-Medical Chemistry, or any equivalent degree from a recognized university with at least 50% marks in aggregate eligible for the same. Department is offering PhD in various fields of chemistry, especially in nanochemistry, environmental chemistry, pharmaceutical chemistry, along with the other basic fields of chemistry. Chemistry provides skills such as written and oral communications, patience and determination, attention to detailed research, scientific and numerical skills, organization, analytical skills, curiosity, and adaptability. We have designed our courses keeping these skills in mind under the supervision and guidelines from UGC. After pursuing the course from our university, the student gets ample opportunities in various sectors of government as well as private, including academia, research, industry, as well as entrepreneurship. In case of academia, a postgraduate in chemistry can work as a primary, secondary, and high school teacher, as well as can work as an academic professional like assistant professor, associate professor, and professor after clearing the UGC NET exam. In the field of research and development, there are ample opportunities like in applied research and product development, chemoinformatics, chemical engineering, chemical technology, crystallography, dyes, pigments, and inks, industrial management, laboratory management, project management. We can also integrate chemistry with other sciences, and the student gets various opportunities as a biochemist, agricultural chemist, archaeological chemist, pharmacologist, nanotechnologist, editor, environmental chemist, geochemist, astrochemist, and science communicator. So these are only some of the opportunities which I have highlighted. The actual opportunities are limitless. Now let me take you to the Department of Chemistry at a view. This is the our earlier batch passing out from Department of Chemistry. These are our faculty members at Department of Chemistry. Myself, Dr. Rajnigar, heading the Department of Chemistry, Dr. Sumanlata, Ms. Shweta Bhardwaj, Mr. Shegil, Mr. Vishal Sharma, and Ms. Rijul, all are net qualified and highly intellectual in their own field. These are our research groups working in the field of nanochemistry, in the field of alternative fuels, and green chemistry at the Department of Chemistry. Our research labs, as I already told you, are well equipped. We have separate labs for inorganic chemistry, physical chemistry, organic chemistry, and applied chemistry. The research labs are also well equipped, and we foster the interest of students right from the undergraduate level. No institution, to my knowledge, provides research work, project work, and dissertation right from the undergraduate level. Our students actively pursue research starting from their BSc course. Department provides excellent opportunities to the students in terms of extracurricular and interdisciplinary approaches. To foster the student knowledge, we organize a collaborative effort in the form of various workshops, conferences at our University School of Sciences. This is some glimpses from our earlier national conference on recent trends in environment science and technology, where our student had actively showcased their research work. Again, this is from year 2017, where we had organized scientific exhibition. In 2018, this was the event where the participants across the nation had showcased their research at various levels, starting from undergraduate, postgraduate, and doctoral level. Recently, in 2019, we had organized exhibition by our own students, including physics, chemistry, life sciences, and mathematics departments. And our students performed amazing experiments and helped the students to cultivate their interest in the field of science. These are the glimpses from the international conference that we had organized in the year of 2017, where not only from India, but across the world, the scientists, the researchers, the students had found a platform and shared their knowledge in their various field of sciences. These are some of the glimpses. Our own students had also showcased their research work in the form of poster presentation. So right from the undergraduate level, ample opportunities are provided to the student. Now, this is our legacy celebration of National Science Day. Every year we celebrate National Science Day, catalyzed by Punjab State Council of Science and Technology, with the help of sponsorship obtained from our national level institutes. We organize National Science Day and provide various opportunities to the students. We invite various experts at this level every year so that students may get extra knowledge apart from the regular academic knowledge. Recently, as Dr. Seema has already told you, we had organized innovation contest for women, where our students not only participated and presented their innovative ideas for controlling pollution problem in Punjab, but also won prizes. A very prestigious Elsevier workshop had been organized in year 2016, where editors from the Elsevier journal came at our institution and provided various skills regarding research paper writing to our students, research scholars, and teachers. Apart from the regular activities, we also aware our students about the various issues prevailing in our society. This is some glimpses from the Cancer Awareness Day, Apart from that, we also hold various workshops in our institution, at our department, so that students may get extra knowledge than the knowledge available at the course books. We invite various experts from reputed institutions so that students may get current edge knowledge. Now, to provide sufficient knowledge about the environment at industries, at scientific labs, the students visit various scientific institutions as well as industries and gain a knowledge and have an interaction with the people over there. These are some of the glimpses. The student had visited Punjab Agricultural University, Ludhiana. Apart from these, we know that a healthy mind can only succeed. So keeping this thing in mind, we organize sports day. This is the some of the glimpses where our students participate in various sports activities organized during annual sports day. Now, to welcome our freshers, every year we organize a very special event, Spandan, in which students show their talent and get the grooming skills. Now, to say goodbye to our students, every year we organize a very heart-touching event named Ruksat. These are some of the glimpses from that. Now, at chemistry department, we develop a special bond. We name it as teacher-student bond. These are our very close, very dear students on the signature day, where they take our signatures with them on their lab coats with which they perform their research work and cherish their memories forever. These are some of the glimpses during the Teachers' Day celebrations. You can see the joy from these pics every year. But in the current situation of COVID-19 this year, we couldn't celebrate personally, physically, this celebration at our campus. So it doesn't mean that we didn't celebrate it. We celebrated it online, and our alumni students also participated. Let's have a glimpse. This is the contribution from our students. A very heart-touching message from our alumni during the Teachers' Day celebration that were carried out online. These are working now. Some of the glimpses from the Lodi celebrations, Holi celebrations, and these are some of the activities we had carried out during the lockdown. Even during the lockdown, we haven't stopped our endure, and we are continuously working on the same. Now, a very important to any department is placement. As a growing discipline, chemistry is at the crossroads of many sciences and placement opportunities for graduate chemistry students, and they have always been better. We provide an interdisciplinary educational and research experience to our students with building of a strong technical foundation so that they must be able to meet the needs of the various sectors, including industry, research, education, and entrepreneurship. Our students have been blessed to secure a place in well-known pharmaceuticals, analytical, and testing laboratories, research, as well as educational institutions. These are some of the glimpses where our students have been placed. This is for batch 2014. These students, only some of the students I have mentioned here, that have been placed. You can see from the names that our students have been placed in various reputed industries such as Onyx Biotech Private Limited, Swiss Garnier Biotech Private Limited, InSwift Laboratory Limited, Biogenetic Drugs Private Limited, Health Biotech Limited, ITC Baddi, Creation Parentals, Ultra Chiron Pharmaceuticals, Ernst Pharmacia, and also at abroad in teaching sector. These are some of the students who have got placed from the batch 2016. Rishabh at Dr. Reddy's lab as a production officer in RK Laboratories, Ms. Priyanka, Mr. Chandan in Unix Biotech, a unit of Cipla, Mandeep at Centred Pharmaceuticals, Shivani at RK Laboratories, Ashish Sharma as Senior Technical Officer, Saraswati Agrochemicals, Rahul Rana in Centred Pharmaceuticals, Gaurav in Sun Pharma, Shweta in Torque Pharmaceuticals, Akash Deep in Sun Pharma. These are some of the students who got placed in year 2017 in IDMA at Centred Pharmaceuticals, ITC Labs, Servotech Pharmaceutical Companies, and Cruise Life Science Private Limited. So basically, placements are not limited. The knowledge that we provide to our students, the skills that we provide, take them ahead in their life. Depending upon the interest of the student, he or she has been well placed in the particular industry, academia, or research. Our students are pursuing PhD from CSIR labs across India. They are also working in various pharmaceutical industries. They are also working in academia and providing knowledge to the students further. So when we see our achievements in the form of our students getting placed, that is no match to anything else. Apart from that, about our faculty is continuously active in the field of research and has published several papers in SCI, Scopus Indexed, national and international journals, as well as UGC CARE journals. So at Department of Chemistry, we provide a perfect blend of academia and research to have an insightful experience. Now, I welcome you all to have a wonderful experience sharing by our alumni. So this is Ms. Jeevan Jog. She has been placed in a meat industry at Canada. So let's So she is sharing her experience. Likewise, we have our student, Ms. Simranjeet Kaur. She is currently pursuing her MSc from Australia.
बोलो उनको जाके। Students, during your 2 years or the 3 years, depending upon the time of your course that you are going to spend in our department, we believe we will provide you the necessary tools, academic, moral, and spiritual for the very challenging life of yours ahead. You will definitely be proud of your achievement that you will be having in your journey with us, ranging from the great scholarly achievements to the extracurricular pursuits. You will enjoy and enrich your knowledge with interaction with your teachers as well as your peers. So my message is, go forth and embrace your future with open arms and enthusiastically pursue your life journey of discovery. Our aim should be to dedicate our service to humanity and to live a happy and peaceful life. By this way only, we can reach the fullness of life, as well as we can achieve our dreams and make a mark in the world as an ambassador. So I invite you again so that you can have your dreams as well as the dreams of your parents come true. I welcome all of you to be driven by the quest for knowledge in the field of chemistry and invite you all to take your time to explore further about us from our site and our Facebook page and discover the other strengths of our department. Once again, I welcome you all in our Department of Chemistry. As a family, we are going to work together. So setting goals is a first step in turning the invisible into the visible. So be honest, be punctual, be determined. Thank you so much. Now, next coming is our HOD of Department of Physics, Dr. M.S. Mehta. He has an ample experience in teaching as well as in research. He has published several papers in various reputed journals at national and international level. He has coordinated various activities in the department at university level. So next with us is Dr. Mehta. I welcome Dr. Mehta. Dr. Mehta, thank you.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Dr. M.S. Mehta, HOD Department of Physics. Extending heartiest welcome to the Riyadwara family. Many things have been told by the speaker, Dr. Simranjeet Kaur and Dr. Bhatnagar. Now I will take directly you to the classroom with the how we carry on the studies in the Department of Physics. So we are offering right now the 6 programs. PhD in physics, and we have 5 periods in nuclear physics, advanced metaphysics, astronomy, astrophysics, and cosmology. The student can do PhD in these fields. We have a talented faculty in all these fields in the department. The like 3 to 4 years after the UGC norms to complete the PhD degree. The student can enter the PhD program from the NET examination or the examination conducted by the university, and doing coursework and then start the research work. So eligibility for this is 50% marks in PhD, MSc. Next program is MSc in Astronomy and Astrophysics. we have started this program from this current session. 30 seats are available for the admission, and this is very exciting specialized course in master degree. In getting a master degree, one can go for the higher studies, PhD, and he or she can join the PhD degree here only, or can go abroad also. And we are sending the students to various parts of the world, recommending them for the PhD programs. And another program is MSc in Physics. This also contains 30 seats, and then three undergraduate programs: BSc Honors in Physics, BSc Physical Sciences, which we call earlier used to call it, non-medical BSc, and BSc B.Ed. Undergraduate programs are three years programs, and this BSc B.Ed is 4-year program. Then these are our faculty members. All are specialized. Myself, Dr. M.S. Mehta. Dr. Deepak, he is specialized in nanoscience, condensed matter physics. And Dr. Harsimran Jyot Kaur, she is also from condensed matter physics. Sanjeev Kumar Sharma, he is from astronomy and astrophysics. And Tanvir Kaur, she is also specialized in applied physics. And these are the class teachers for the first year. Students for MSc first class, Sanjeev Kumar Sharma, and for the BSc first year, Deepak Agnihotri. And the important part of the program is teaching and learning. So teaching and learning will be successful only if there will be presence in the class, and teacher will be able to deliver if the students have maximum presence in the class. So 75% attendance is mandatory for the students. Then inside the class, how to deliver the lecture. During this this period of COVID-19, only online classes will be there, and this chalkboard teaching will not be there. Now it will be pen board teaching, and also the PowerPoint presentation or video clips. Then how we will complete the unit? We will complete the unit conceptually first, and then mathematical formulation, because without mathematics, physics cannot be studied or learned. And finally, we'll go for the numerical problems in order to realize the concepts of the physics, how they produce the result. Then is the student-teacher interaction. The student-teacher interaction will be through the seminars, quizzes, and discussion, class tests. The discussion is the most important part in the teacher-student interaction. Without discussion, the student cannot gain experience and cannot clarify the concepts of the physics. Then is the evaluation scheme. For the UG and PG, there will be theory paper of 100 marks. That will be having three components. One is continuous evaluation, which is further having three components. One component is assignment, getting 10 marks, tests or quizzes, 5 marks, and seminars of 5 marks. And another will be midterm test, getting 30 marks. There will be two midterm tests, and for a final calculation, average of the two will be taken. And finally, there will be end-term examination carrying 50 marks, and this all will be calculated for the final grade of the student. In the laboratory, in the same way, there will be 100 marks paper, again having three components: continuous evaluation, which contains the performance in the laboratory, and Viva, and the record of the observational points. Then midterm test, there will be one midterm test carrying 25 marks, and finally there will be end term examination carrying 50 marks. In this continuous evaluation, students have to submit the experiment in every third lab, and Viva will be conducted and evaluated at the same time. Then passing out eligibility from the program, when the student completes the program, 3 years or 2 years, whatever it is, for the UGC 3 years, the CGPA should be minimum 5.0, or for PG it should be 5.5. If the CGPA is less than 5 for UG and less than 5.5 for PG, then there will be a chance to improve the grade. Otherwise, for the other having 6.0 or 5.6 or something, no chance will be given for the improvement of the grade. In case any student fail to meet the minimum requirements, they are placed in two categories. One is the RRA category, we call it, required to register again. This will be student will be placed only in this category when the attendance is less than 75. And second category is F grade, student will be failed. This F grade will be awarded in two ways. Either the student secures less than 30% in the end term examination, or end term examination plus continuous evaluation is less than 35%. In that case, the student will be given F grade. Laboratory work, right now there will be no physical work in the laboratory. We'll conduct the laboratory work through the demonstration classes only, online. And this work will be observed only when physical classes will be conducted. And next, what we have to do in this program? The studies came for the physics first semester. So these are the subjects carrying 4 credits, and some of the courses are of 2 credits, some of the courses are of 1 credit. So these are two small courses are for the skill enhancement of the students, and this essential management, for example, is the ability enhancement course, and professional visit is also there, and seminar is also there. This is also skill enhancement course. Similarly, for the astronomy and astrophysics, we have these subjects which will be common for some of the for the physics MSc physics also. In BSc physical sciences non-medical, all the three subjects will be taught at the first semester and second semester: physics, chemistry, and mathematics. Also, on some open subject chosen from the university for the skill ability enhancement. For example, this English and communication and soft skills. Term paper. In this term paper, students are given the experience of writing the paper, how to write the research paper, how to read and how to make the documentation, and mentoring. Every student will be given a mentor, and he or she can discuss his or her problems with the mentor in order to find out the solutions. This is for the honors first year. In the honors first year, we have two physics courses, one chemistry and one mathematics. And this curriculum is in this program specific is the syllabus, and other curriculum supplement curricular activities will be there. In addition to the curriculum, there will be some small projects having calculations, small calculations, and plotting the graph, writing the documents, how the whatever the students observe in the books, how these graphs or the observations come out. These activities are conducted during the course of the semester. In extra curricular activities, social activities will be conducted. For example, the social awareness among the society people around about the pollution and global warming, various problems existing due to the this problem, women pesticides, etc. There are so many social activities. So there is a club in the physics department. This club is a student club known as Graviton. This club conducts many activities during the semester, like poster presentation, paper presentation, presentation of models, working models, non-working models, quizzes, and the activities on the notice board, etc. In addition to this, we will observe the World Energy Conservation Day on 14th December 2020 and National Science Day on 28th February 2021. So after completing the course, BSc course, these are the job opportunities for the students having a BSc degree. On the left hand side, it is which type of jobs or where the jobs can be obtained. And in the central block, it is the universities and institute where the student can get employment. On the right hand side, the positions, which type of job can a student can have in these organizations. And in case a student go for higher education, then he or she can go for MSc Physics, MSc Applied Physics, MSc Nanotechnology, MSc Astrophysics, MSc Cosmology, Astronomy, etc. There are so many other programs also for the master degree once one completes the BSc successfully. In the after MSc, these are the opportunities for the students to join as observational scientists, laboratory technician, research analyst, scientists grade C. After C, you will be promoted to D, E, F, and G in the various institutes like ISRO, BARC, DRDO, ISERS. There are more than 10 ISERS in our country. So the student, after doing MSc, can join these institutes and central universities. One is there, Indian Institute of Astronomy, ARES at Nainital, IECO at Bengaluru. And if after MSc any student want to go for higher studies, he or she can go for PhD either by completing UGC NET or by qualifying the university examination, or even a student can go abroad for the PhD programs. There are so many openings coming daily from across the world. So any student willing to go, we always guide the student to get admission across the world for the PhD programs. Then lastly, save energy. Save the energy in terms of light, wind, and other things. In a way, energy, everything is energy. Save money is also energy. Everything is energy, so we should be careful about energy. So if we save energy, we can have a good reservoir for the future life. Next is save nature. If we save the nature, we plant a sapling, it will be helping us again by producing oxygen. If we inhale maximum oxygen, our cells will be active, and immunity of the body will increase accordingly. And finally, thank you very much for the patience and all this. Next will be Dr. Ravneet Kaur, Associate Professor in Mathematics Department. She will be presenting the Mathematics Department. So over to Dr. Ravneet Kaur.
Formed by the government bodies. We have focused on nurturing the talent of all our students since the inception of the school. Our faculty members are looking forward to impart quality education and helping you to understand the fundamentals and the basic concepts of the subjects, not only in particularly mathematics, but also sciences, social sciences, English, environmental sciences, human values, and many more subjects. We value discipline and inculcate the same and expect the same from you, dear students. Our focus is creating future leaders and thinkers with creativity and the moral values. We not only focuses on the classroom teaching, but also we are open to take the student doubts and the problems, whatever you have during your stay with us at the university. Even feedback about anything, any problem you are having here, or anything you would like to give us or tell us about the quality of teaching is always welcomed by each and every faculty member. Tender behavior, congenial environment, quality teaching are the key features of the faculty of Department of Mathematics. So I again welcome you all to Department of Mathematics, University School of Sciences. In all, we welcome you to Riyadh Bahra University. So now I'm just going through what we take up in the department through a PPT presentation. So welcome you all. Myself, Ravneet Kaur. So this is about the Riyadh Bahra University. So these are the key functionaries of the university. They own this university, they planned, they have this university with the aim to become a channel for giving national and international voice to innovation and ultimately playing a lead role in placing India on the global forefront by providing skilled human resources for the job market. Now about Department of Mathematics, we have a very reputed Dr. C.P. Gandhi, myself, Madam Ravneet Kaur, Mr. Rohit and Mr. Mohan Kaushik. All are well qualified and very good in imparting the quality education. Now, first of all, everyone thinks that why we take up mathematics, because it seems to be a tough subject, although it is a very important part of each and every subject. Nobody can work without mathematics. Even the household works cannot go without mathematics. So this is all about importance of mathematics. Mathematics is a rigorous and demanding intellectual pursuit, long though, as per opinion, it's tough thinking about many more people. People think that it's very tough, but according to us, it's very easy if you have a basic understanding of the things. according to some people, it's interesting, exciting, and challenging subjects. Those who work on the subject, those who have knowledge of each and every part of the subject, those who don't grasp the things, those who try to learn, understand the key problems, basics of the subject, they take it very interesting, exciting, and a challenging subject. People likes its clarity and the satisfaction of knowing when you have the right answer to a problem. Definitely, when you would like, when you have any question in mind, when you have some doubt in mind, you always ask why, when, how this happened. That is how maths work. It always talks about the concept clarity, how that problem is formulated, when that problem is formulated, why that problem formulated. That is what mathematics do. So now, what is the role of mathematics department? Our mission is, mathematics is not about making you learn calculations, how to deal with numbers, how to deal with equations only. It gives you analytic thinking, sharpness in mind, and skills. Moreover, the vision of mathematics department is to provide jobs to each and every student, whether it is in the government sector or it is in the private organization. In fact, mathematics, it is an inherent and the integral part of engineering and science. No subject can work without mathematics. Even I go for any engineering subject, I go for any type of subject, every subject go along with the mathematics. For example, if I take up engineering, an engineer cannot work without mathematics. For a very basic example, like something is rotating, rotations, calculations, there come mathematics. So how we can say mathematics is not important? Mathematics is definitely, it is integrated with all the subjects. So engineers need to be able to formulate practical engineering problems in the mathematical terms. All the engineers, they work, they try to formulate the things. At the end, they end up with a mathematical model. So what are mathematics people do? They do the error correcting codes. They solve the problems, they do the numerical calculations, they help them in finding the solution of the problems they are not able to do. Even for taking anything to the planets or working with the universe, mathematics play a key role. Mathematics theory instruct the superconductors what work to be done. They command the computers also. Even in the other fields like physics, chemistry, biology, and many other subfields, mathematics, it acts as a catalyst and in the problem solving. Without mathematics, no reaction can take place. Without mathematics, no transportation can do. Without mathematics, nothing can flow. Even in biology, even in the body, cells move, cells run here and there. They use mathematics. So why to do mathematics? Everyone have this in mind, which subject to do, why to do. What is the scope of this subject? Why should we opt this subject? So I'm just introducing or letting you make to understand what are the career opportunities after doing BSc Mathematics or MSc in Mathematics. So you can go for research. You can work as an operation research analyst. You can work as an actuary, that is risk calculators. You can act as a data analyst. You can work with banks. You can work as a teaching professor. You can work with the insurance company, or you can moreover work with the astronomy, and there are many more fields. I'm not specifying all. But in our courses, we not only focuses on mathematics, but we focus on the overall development of the student. Not only about the key subjects of mathematics, it's about the environmental studies, it's about the this communication skills, your English enhancement, a good moral values, human values, even different your psychology. So we work with the integral of all the subjects. We not only make you a mathematics person, we make you a very good human being. So these are few subjects. I'm just highlighting them that we have many more subjects along with this. This is what we'll be taking up only in the first semester. So we have two semesters, 1 year, all is CBCS system. So similarly, in MSc Mathematics, we have many subjects. As we deal with the management also, students should have a good handling of things. like you're working with some company, you're working as a researcher, you should have a congenial environment, you should have a congenial system, you should have a good behavior, you should have good moral values, so that you can have a good behavior and good friends, so you can work with all the others. So for that, we have all the different subjects, different things we are inculcating in the same stream. So for example, we have modern algebra, we have complex, solid mechanics, differential geometry, real analysis. Apart from this, we have essentials of management. These are the few subjects, but otherwise, for your these courses, we offer, in the last year, we offer you the project work. During your BSc course, we offer major and minor project. For that, you need to go through some research papers. You need to write a report. You need to have a basic understanding of particular any problem, whatever you are interested in subject. Then after that, we would help you to solve the problem. We would make you, give you ideas. We have very good faculty. We'll tell you how that problem can be solved with different techniques and different methods. So, like, sky is not the limit. Similarly, in mathematics, there is no limit. You can solve a problem with using any technique, from a simple partial differential equation with a simple exactness method to any type of numerical method. You can solve any problem with any way. So there are different features of using subjects and dealing with the subjects. Similarly, we have mentoring classes also. We have scientific visit also. We have your industrial visits also during your this stay with us. For these, like for the scientific visit, we just want you all to have a very vast vision, that it is not that you are only restricted to our school life. That means during your stay in the school, we will make you to understand your importance as a mathematician, your importance, what you will give to the world, where will you be placed. So for that, we prefer to give you a scientific visit to some place where mathematics is practically being applied. Similarly for BSc students, they give you the scope, they tell you how they are using, how they are implementing the things. So that is, they just elaborate you the significance of whatever is taught to you, or whatever you will be understanding, whatever you will be learning. Now, apart from the study, we have few things, like we have attendance criteria, we have minimum marks percentage that you need to clear the semester. So 75% attendance is compulsory for sitting in MSc as well as in NTM exams. Students are not allowed to sit in the examination without the attendance fulfillment. It is very compulsory. You have to attend the classes, whether it is going on virtual classes or you have a classroom study. iCards are also compulsory. All students are required to wear iCards when they are in the college premises. At the entrance of the gate, that iCard will be checked. If you are wearing it, you will be allowed to enter the university. If you are not wearing it, you will not be allowed to enter university. Similarly, misbehavior and ragging is completely prohibited. Nobody is allowed to rag anyone. Nobody is allowed to conduct any type of misbehavior, misconception, any type of irregularity or any type of misbehavior is not acceptable in the campus. So anyone who's found guilty will be punished according to whatever the college authorities do. So after MSc marks and the attendance, it will be communicated to the parents and to the family, so that they should be aware what the child is, what the dear student is doing here, whether he's doing very good, he's average, so that they may also help you, they may also guide you. Students, they will be assigned mentor and class interviewers. Now, mentoring means that if you are having any doubt, any clarity, you need any clarity, you have any problem, you can discuss it with your mentor. Mentor, keep your things very secretly with him or her. They don't share it to anyone. They try to solve the problem at their own level, and they try to help you whenever you need it. Class and charges will be assigned to you. They are like the faculty who will be taking the record of your attendance, of your MSc marks. They will be contacting your parents. They will have an interaction with your parents, so that your parents may also feel that there is someone they can talk to every time about how their child is doing, what he is doing, whether he's attending classes, how he is behaving, whether he's missing something or any type of thing, the class in charges can be communicated and talked about. These are also few career opportunities, like after doing your MSc and BSc. Few are like they want to do jobs due to their own potential or due to their whatever they want. So there may be some students who after BSc would like to go for doing jobs in banks, or they would like to do B.Ed or any other career opportunity they would like to go for. Similarly, after doing your master's, they would like to go for either for the research, or they would like to go for any type of exam, or they would like to go for any higher education, maybe PhD or any other type of one. So as a teacher, there are few teaching opportunities that you can go for your career. Like there are few fields where every teacher is required, like in BTech, BCA, BCom, BPharmacy, BBA, MBA, BA with mathematics, BSc in agriculture. During your stay here in BSc, we always prefer and we always do, we increase your basic concepts. Like in basic concepts, you are preparing for your bank. So that will help you in preparing your banking exams and various other type of examinations. Now, similarly, the higher study in mathematics. If you want to go for higher study after doing your master degree or BA, BSc degree or any other degree, you can opt for BA, BSc after plus two. You can go for IIT JAM exam. After that, you can go for MSc in mathematics, stats, applied science. Even we are going for biostats also. This year, we have started another subject, MSc in biostatistics. After doing your MSc, you can go for many options. You can go for NBHM, TIFR, you can go for CSIR NET, you can go for GRF, you can go for PhD. So these are the higher studies if you are a keen study or you have the caliber that you want to earn very good and very high in mathematics. So apart from the teaching, classroom teaching, we have various other events in the campus. There are few glimpses. We always organize expert talks. We always organize Technoversa. We always organize Teachers Day, and we organize various like National Science Day conferences, national and international level. So these are few glimpses. I'm just going you through this glimpses so that you feel that you're not only restricted to the classroom study. So in these glimpses, I'm just presenting that there are the expert talks organized. We also do things for the social contribution, like blood donation camps, tree plantation. Even the students enthrall the floor with their dance and singing. So due to this COVID-19, as we are taking up the virtual classes, this year we celebrate Teacher Day through virtual. So this is a screen, this is a picture. I'm just showing you that we celebrate everything, whether we are having a classroom teaching or we are taking up the virtual things. So see, students join, students enjoy, they talk, they interact with us every time. So the goals of our department: to get better results, to be able to be an effective analyzer, to generate new ideas, to have good personality and command over the subject, as well as over your moral values, to make students to improve socially, to integrate the community and reach the new heights, so that you can proudly say everyone that, yes, I am from Riyadh Bhara University. So thank you very much. So this is by Tony Robbins. Setting goal is the first step in turning the invisible into a visible thing. So during your stay at Riyadh Bhara University, you will definitely enjoy, learn. After that, you will be proud that, yes, I'm from a Riyadh Bhara University. I am a Riyadh Bhara University student. Apart from this, few students would like to interact with you, and they would like to show that how was their stay at Riyadh Bhara University. Thank you very much.
University with Masters in Chemistry in 2017 batch. I'm in Canada working as a food scientist in a meat industry. During my Masters, I got an excellent opportunity to work as an intern in a bakery industry as a QLT assurance technician, where I excel my knowledge and experience. I gained transferable and technical skills during 2 years program in Raipur University, including hands-on experience on laboratory technique, time management, project management, and work in a group, communicate properly during the presentation. Apart from knowledge, I believe communication plays an important role when it comes to communicate your ideas in front of 50 people. So the professors in Radbara are approachable, cooperative, and always there for your assistance. During my studies, all the professors were rich in knowledge. I can say one expert advice can save you a lot of time during the project. So always seek the expert advice from your professors. I am sure that you will excel as a chemist. And I'm grateful for the whole department for giving me skills, opportunity, knowledge to present myself boldly into the working world. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for your words are illuminized. And I would also like to thank Ravneet ma'am for the delightful words for the students for the e-orientation. So moving to the end of the orientation, I would like to end up this orientation with the words, famous William Blake words: art is the tree of life, science is the tree of death. By this word, I would like to close and end up this e-orientation program for you. I would like to thank you students, parents, and all our HODs for their support and their patience. I could bet you that if could you have been like present in the auditorium, it would have been the different experience to you. So with this, I would like to say one more thing. Stay safe, stay home, take care, bye.